Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about abstaining and enduring. And what I mean by that is that there are certain things in our lives that we do, addictions or habits or things that we do that cause us to really stumble, and they wreck our lives, wreck other people's lives. And there's certain things that other people can do responsibly, and they can have them, but then there's other things that some of us do that we can't do responsibly, and so we have to abstain from those things. We have to stop doing them, and we just have to endure the need and the temptation that may go with it. As an example, there's some people that can drink alcohol responsibly, and it's not a problem for them, but there's other people who can't drink. They, you know, obviously because of genetics or whatever, they get drunk, and it just becomes a disaster. So what is normal and healthy and allowable for some people may not be normal and allowable and healthy for you. And so we can either continue to keep trying to keep these things in our lives and let them wreck our lives, or we can cut them out. Let me just read you a scripture real quick. And this is Jesus speaking. It's out of Mark 9. It says, "If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than have two hands and go to hell, where the fire never goes out. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life crippled than to have two feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have two eyes and be thrown into hell, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. Everyone will be salted with fire." Now that may sound really radical to you, to cut off parts of your bodies, but you know, it kind of talks about you know, if wherever you go, like with your foot, whatever you do, like with your hand, or whatever you're looking at, if there's things that you're doing or places you're going or things that you're looking at that cause you to sin, you need to cut them out, and you've got to be very, very serious about it, because hell is a very, very real place. It's not just a frame of mind or some place that you don't want to go to here on the earth. It's a real place that's within the earth. It's where humans go that reject God, reject the sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross, and they're there right now. There's a lot of people, some you may have even known here, that are there right now, 4,300 miles underneath you, that are suffering horribly in hell. And it's hard to hear that kind of thing, but you know what? Whatever the truth is, that's what you've got to be interested in. We can, you know, live in denial all we want, but if this hell place really exists and you really can go there, then guess what? You need to know about it. We all need to know about it, and we need to have that information here. Satan, you know, the devil, doesn't want you to have that information, because he wants you to just kind of go through your life and hope that you'll make it in somehow in the end. But according to what God says, that's not the way that it goes. So that there's certain things that other people can do. Sexual perversion is another example. There's other people that can have sex normally, you know, and it's not a problem for them or anyone else. But then there's other people who, because they've misdeveloped sexually, whatever, they have sexually perverse desires, and they just cannot practice sex healthy without sinning or without hurting other people. Well, guess what? You may have to cut sex out of your life altogether. You may have to abstain and endure so that you don't sin, so that you can avoid hell, like Jesus was talking about. You've got to cut it out of your life. And there's a lot of you listening right now, whether you're somebody fighting an addiction or whether you're somebody just trying to repent of sin because you're getting ready for the harvest, getting ready for Jesus to return. And God is telling you right now today, look, you've got to take the final step, and you've got to just cut this thing out. There's no way that you can live with it. There's no way that you can do it without sinning, hurting yourself or hurting other people. So you've got to get serious, and you've got to cut it out, because it's not worth this thing leading you to hell in the end. What good is it going to do you, like Jesus said, to have what looks like a successful life and everything intact, but be practicing this thing and then end up going to hell in the end, and it was for nothing. All this was for nothing. So God doesn't want you to go to hell. He says that God's not willing that any should perish. That means God wants everybody to go to heaven, including you. Everybody is God's creation. If you're a human being, you're part of God's creation, and he wants you to be saved. And The reason that we go to hell is just not because God's mean and or he's a perfectionist. It's because we've broken his laws. Adam broke his laws, and all the descendants broke his laws after that. If you've broken any of the Ten Commandments, if you've ever lied, if you've ever stolen, if you've ever lusted after somebody, anything like that, then you're guilty of one sin, and you can't enter heaven with even one sin. And the only person that can pay for your sin is Jesus Christ, and that's how God set it up. But God wants you to be saved. He wants you to be able to go to heaven and to be with him forever. Now, if there is something, like if you have a sexual perversion problem and you can't have sex normally and you need to cut that out, or an addiction thing like with alcohol or other things, whatever it is, if there is something you need to cut out, you've got to convince yourself that you can live without it. And there's a lot of things that we do. We say, oh, I can't live without that. I can't live without smoking, or I can't live without, you know, sexual perversion. Well, by the way, pornography is sexual perversion. And if there is something that you feel that you cannot live without, then think again. I mean, nobody's got a gun to your head. Nobody can force you to do these things. You're doing them by your own choice. No matter what your genetics are, what your excuses are, you're doing it. You notice you never walk up to your pastor and just let off a big, you know, flurry of profanity. And you never view porn while everybody's standing around. Well, that's what I'm saying. Nobody's forcing you to do this. You're choosing it. And I was at a Bible study once where the leader told some kid to get up and pull his pants down. And when the kid got up, he goes, well, I'm not going to pull my pants down. And the leader of it said, well, why not? He goes, because I don't want to. And he was just showing an example that you really don't want to do something, then guess what? You have a choice. And you have a choice not to do this thing if you really don't. And you've got to take it seriously that the way that God set things up, you may not think it's fair, but that's how he set things up, that people do go to hell. This is what it says in 1 Corinthians 6:9. Do you not know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of God? That means you go to the other place, hell. Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers or swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. So he's really laying it out there, and you've got to be willing to starve the lies that have been operating in your life. Sin is a big lie, and you've got to get God's truth, which is in the Bible, and you've got to live by it. And don't think that you're going to overcome this problem by just constantly be practicing the lie or viewing the lie or doing the lie. It's just not going to happen. You'll never be able to walk in the truth if you're just constantly walking in the lie. You've got to stop it. You've got to, like I said, you've got to cut it out. And you've got to do it today, because you don't know how long you're going to live on this earth. People think they're going to be here for 70 years. Guess what? They're gone in a second. There's lots of people that have gone in car accidents or had heart attacks that thought they had many years left, and they're just gone. And when your heart beats its last beat, that's it. You don't have any more chances. There's no way to change anything. But listen to this too. It says, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So Paul's saying all these people existed back in his day too, but they found the help that they needed through God to overcome it. And sometimes there is no overcoming it necessarily, except to cut it out of your life, and that's what you're going to have to do. Now, Jesus Christ is returning soon to the earth to set up his kingdom here for 1,000 years. There's a tribulation, like it talks in Revelation, that looks very likely that it could come within our lifetime or our children's lifetime, where we have to be ready to leave here, because the whole crop here is going to be harvested all at once. And if you could sit in the grandstands in heaven and see the judgment going on and see people like porn actors or whoever it is, the things up on a big screen of what everybody's done, if you could see that here on earth right now, you would just flat out stop it, because you don't want to be in that hot seat. Well, guess what? You're already set up for that hot seat right now, and the only way that you can edit out the movie of your life is to cut these things out of your life, to stop doing them, to be willing to abstain, stop doing it, and to endure the need. And you know what? Don't feed the need. If you've got a problem with sexual perversion or addiction, don't do things that feed the need. And meet right needs in right ways, and don't meet wrong needs in wrong ways, and don't even meet right needs in wrong ways. So ask God for your help. He will help you. And like I said, Jesus is returning soon. And this is, if you're, you know, about to go into this harvest, this last harvest, if you're coming out of the wilderness, it says here in Revelation 22, blessed are those who wash their robes, that they may have the right to eat of the tree of life and to go through the gates of cities. Outside are all the people that do wrong. So cut these things out of your life. Trust God. Pray and ask Jesus into your heart, and ask God to help you with these things, to cut them out. Okay? Bless you. Bye-bye.